We greet you all that have joined us on the live stream for this Yam, the day Teruach. It is the sounding of the alarm. It is the sounding of the shofar. It is the soundness of the great joy, the great gladness. It is the soundness of preparation, the variants of this Moed. It presents more indications, or it acclaims to such variants. You must study the Torah to understand. We're going to have the Achim tonight. They're going to come from various perspectives as to the importance, the value of this day, what it implies. I'm simply going to be here for a few moments. I want to read a few chatuv, a few scriptures, that we can see what Yah says concerning Teruach. Teruach, the sounding of the alarm, the blowing of the shofar. It calls us to shout Hallel. That is the shout. That's what Teruach is. And so we bring unto him the offering this day, the offering that is offered by the fire, by the Isha, by the fragrance of sweet fragrance unto his nostrils. And what a great blessing that he grants unto us, that we can remember this Moed, this Zikron. It become a memorial in our mind. It is one of the most important days of the Moedim. Not that one is less important, but because what this day signifies, it signifies so many variations and variants of what shall be and what shall come and what will be introduced. It's beyond comprehension. So we're going to allow the Achim to instruct us in that tonight, Yisrael. But before our Zawkane come, I want you to give us credence as to the time that we're in. I have five verses I want to read. Hallelujah. I'm glad that he has elected me. I'm glad of that. You don't have to rejoice, but I'm so glad that Yah has elected me and that he calls me his son. Let the redeemed of Yah say so. It says here in the book of Yirah, in the book of Leviticus 23, one verse I want to read here. He says, I want you to speak unto the being, the children of Israel, and I want you to utter out of your mouth, he says, in the seventh month. Yah has ordained every day. He said, in the seventh month, in the first day of the month, you shall have a Shabbat. You shall have a Shabbaton. It should be a time whereby there should be no servile labor. It tells us you don't work from sundown to this evening until sundown tomorrow. You lay aside all of your little actions and your activities. He said, it shall be a Shabbaton. It shall be a Shabbaton in this first day. And he says, it shall be a memorial, a zikron. It shall be engraved in your mind. It shall be remembered throughout the times to pass on to the generation. He said, it shall be a memorial of the blowing of the shofar. It shall be a teruach. It shall be a blowing of the shofar. He says, because it is a chag mikra. It is a convocation that is set apart. It is a time to cause the ayin and the ears of his nation. That's why he says unto Moshe, speak, utter unto the children of Yisrael. Make your words plain that they may understand. And there is one that understood the beauty of this like no other man. His name is Dawid. I want to read from Tehillim. Hallelujah. It says in the book of Tehillim, Psalms 47. That's why this is a time of great exerting ourselves to esteem, to elevate, to exalt the very power of our Abba. David says in Tehillim, Psalms 47:5, he says, Almighty Yah, the great one, the Abba, Almighty Yahweh, he has gone up with a shout, a teruach. He has gone up with a sound, an alarm. This is a signal to us, Yisrael. This is a signal of preparation for the coming of Yahshua HaMashiach. We can't take the Mo'adim of Yah lightly. We cannot say that, oh, it's all right if I don't celebrate. It is wrong. He calls it a Shabbat. It is a Shabbaton. It is a time of rest. You don't labor. You don't work. It is a Shabbaton unto Yah. It is just like a Shabbat. When a man said he loves Yah and keeps not his mitzvah, his commandments, he's a liar and the truth is not in that man. It shall be a memorial of the blowing of the shofar, a set apart day for us. Yah has gone up in the shout with this great tempest, this blast of the shofar has sounded. Yahshua comes. There shall be, that's all right, play it and blow it. There shall be a great shout and the sound in the alarm city. Yah has gone up with a shout. It says, Yah with the sound, with the call, with the oil, the mighty voice of the shofar. He has gone up. He makes his entrance with the sound of the shofar. He shall present himself with that sound. That's why this Moed is vitally important. I know those that will say, well, Pesach, all of them important. But there is none that make pronouncements with such clarity as this hour and this time. He has not granted unto us men that will not understand these things precisely. David says here in Tehillim 81:3, he says, blow! Teruah, blow! The shofar in the month or in the Kodesh. He commands us to blow it. He says, in the fullness of the appointed time on our feast day. Isn't that a simple thing to do? You find those that cannot and will not do it. We must blow, we must teruach. We must give the sound of Hallel, of praises and the shout of victory unto Yah in Yahshua HaMashiach. That is what we must do, Yisrael. That is simple to do, isn't it? But we have it difficult doing it. It's not hard to do that. We find it difficult. The simple things that he tells us and commands us to do, we find them difficult, don't we? Because everyone wants to be an expert. Everyone wants to be excellent in their knowledge and they think they know, but they don't know, Yisrael. Isn't that so simple? Blow that thing, little one. Blow the shofar. Someone blow at you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the time that we as a nation, we express with great gladness the great rejoicing and the joy of our redemption through Yahshua HaMashiach. This day has such great importance. The alarm has always been a sound of the Teruach. David give us such great inspiration here in Psalms 98 and 6. He says, with the trumpet and the sound. With the trumpet and sound. As our Zawkane brought out to us, he is talking about the call, the sound. And when Yah says the sound, he means for us to do it with a loud voice and with a strong purpose. With the trumpet and the loud sound of the shofar. He said, make a joyful noise unto Yah. So he tells us how to make it. You do it with the sound of the shofar. He said, make a joyful noise unto Almighty Yah. Why? Because our Redeemer lives. Because our Redeemer lives. He has redeemed us. He has brought us from the bondage of sin and darkness. He has liberated us. He has given us the mind of his HaMashiach. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He has caused us to be an excellent people. He has advanced us above all nations. And because of that, there is a teruach that he commands. And who is more intimate with the very sound of Yah's Shofar than David? I want to turn it over to Zawkane after I read this. Psalms 150, verse 3. He tells us here in verse 3 to halal, to praise Yah. When he says halal, he means to do it boastfully, with an arrogant sound, that I don't give a damn what the world says. He commands us to praise him and allow our voices to shine with great radiance. He said, praise him. He said, praise Yah with the sound of this day of shofar. Praise him with all of your sorcery and the harp and all of the instruments. He means what he says. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we hallelujah. Come on, Zawkane, with the sound of the excellence of what he has created. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Truly, this is a Yom, and this is the beginning of days that we should berate Abba Yahweh for everything that he has done. We should open our mouths, our lungs, with the shouting of our voices, with the sounding of the shofar. Let everything that has breath, that has the sound, Barak, praise Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And what a beautiful time and a beautiful day it is that Yahweh causes us and commands us to remember. It's something that we as a people, we remember the smallest of infractions that someone do unto us. We remember things even in our childhood that my brother did to me, that my friend in school did to me, first, second, third grade. But yet Yahweh commands us to zakah, to remember his feast days, his Yom, his days. And we as a nation and as a people have forgotten those things totally. Almost have been wiped out from our minds and from our lives and from our hearts. So what we should do at times like this, as we receive knowledge and revelation and understanding by the Ruach HaKodesh of Almighty Yahweh, we need to redeem that time that we have lost, Yisrael. Because we don't have the time and the space that we once had. So in this understanding of this day of praise, of exaltation to Almighty Yah, Yisrael, we should give it all that we have. Hallelujah. We should praise Almighty Yahweh with all that within us. We should fight this battle of Emunah with everything that is within us, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, for Yahweh is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. I'm just going to say a few words here, Yisrael. I have something I want to express to us somewhat at the end of everything, or the climax of this evening. Our first speaker tonight is going to be Zawkane Benjamin. He's going to speak, but before he comes, Yisrael, I just want us to stay in the Ruach throughout these feast days, even unto the great last day after Sukkot. Because even this day entails the beginning. It talks about the shofar, the blowing of the shofar, does it not? And also at that same beginning, the shofar ends it all. Hallelujah. It ends it all. Is not Yahweh the creator? He began all things. Well, he also has the power and he ends all things. Whether it's life, he begins life, he ends it. He is the light of the world, but also he controls the darkness, YAHSHUA. So let us give todah unto YAHWEH in all things. In trials, in tribulation. Why? Because it is those things that make us stronger, YAHSHUA, if we abide in Torah. It is those things that give us the ability to move and to press on to see what the end of all things shall be if we will continue in Torah. Hallelujah. So at this time, I'm not going to prolong. We're going to ask that Zawkane would come forth. Hallelujah. What YAHWEH has placed on his heart tonight. Hallelujah. Zawkane bend to me. Hallelujah. Let's pour out YAHWEH with a hearty hallelujah, YAHWEH.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Todiah, Todiah. Don't you know that the shofar, the great sounding of the shofar, is predicated on YAHWEH, YAHSHUA. Yes. Don't you know he loves the blowing of the shofar unto him, YAHSHUA. Let us read to understand about this shofar, this great shofar that YAH has commanded his people to blow. And Brother Moshe was telling us, YAHSHUA, for the shofar is to prepare his people. Let us start with Shemot Exodus 19 and 12. To hear as the Torah was read on Mount Sinai. Exodus 19 and 12 says, and you, Moshe, shall set bound to the people round about, saying, take heed to yourself. And on these feast days, we should take heed to ourselves. We should let the word search our lives, YAHSHUA, that you go not unto the mount, I touch the border of it. Why, Moshe, let us know. For there is a reason. Whosoever touches the mount shall be surely put to death. YAHSHUA. As it goes on further to tell us, Exodus 19 and 13, there shall not a hand touch it, but he shall surely be stoned or shot. Oh, through whether it be beast or man, it shall not live. When the shofar sound, long, then they shall come up to the mountain. Oh, but when they come, Moshe, is there a certain thing they got to do? Can they just come up to the mountain? Let us know, Moshe, for we're listening. Our ears open to your word. And Moshe went down from the mount to the people. And he set apart the people. And what did he tell them to do? Oh, he said that they washed their clothes, YAHSHUA. Do you remember when you were washed in the blood? It just wasn't the way that YAH accepted you. For he washed you with that precious blood to make you heal. Exodus 19 and 14. Come on, Moshe. Tell us some more. For this is YAH's day, and we want to hear about this shofar. Moshe went down from the mount. Exodus 19 and 15 said, and he said to the people, be ready against the what day, Moshe, the third day, and approach, as the word is said, no Sabbath work, no having no intimacy with your wife, For Yah commanded that Yisrael. It said Exodus 19 and 16. And it came to pass on the third day in the morning that there was thunder and lightning and a thick cloud upon the mount. And the voice of the shofar, exceedingly loud, Yisrael, exceedingly loud, that they have their ears open, that they may hear. Oh, listen what it said. So that all the people that were in the camp tremble, Yisrael. Oh, the trembling today, Yisrael. Oh, we hear the thunder and the lightning, Yisrael. You know what we would do. We will run, Yisrael. And then we hear the voice, we will even run faster, Yisrael. But it says here that they tremble, Yisrael. Ain't much trembling today, Yisrael. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we need some trembling, Yisrael. Oh, in Exodus 19 and 17, Shema, Moshe brought forth the people out of the camp to meet with Yah, oh, Almighty Yah. And they stood part of the mount. Exodus 19 and 18 said, and Mount Sinai was all together of this great and mighty Yahweh on a smoke, because Yahweh descended upon it, Yisrael. For he was like fire, Yisrael. Don't you know, Yisrael? Sometimes it takes the fire of the word, Yisrael, to burn. That's not of Yah. Out of our land, Yisrael. Oh, yes, Yahweh. This is your feast. Oh, I told you for making me part of your feast this day. Because as he descended upon it in the fire, the smoke thereof ascended as most smoke of a furnace. And the whole mount quaked, Yisrael. Oh, we need to quake, Yisrael. We need to quake, Yisrael. When that word comes to us, Yisrael, to show us of our shortcomings. Oh, we need to quake, Yisrael. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, ain't you glad you're a part of the feast, Yisrael? Oh, Almighty Yahweh invited you once again, Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, the word about the world, Yisrael. But what a greater place to be than in this house, Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. She must access 19 and 19. And when the voice of the shofar sounded long, let me hear the shofar blow, Yisrael. Let me hear that sweet sound of the shofar. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. And when the voice of the shofar sounded long and waxed louder and louder, yes, Moshe spoke. And Yahweh answered him by voice. Oh, yes, he will. He will answer you. It ain't just a sound that's to be made. Yahweh hears that sound just like you, Yisrael. Oh, and it said he will answer him by a voice. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Totally, Yah. Oh, yes. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, the shofar is just not the blowing of the shofar, Yisrael. Oh, but it's a great sound unto Yahweh. Oh, yes. It's called the shofar as a time that Yahweh will answer his people. And we can hear. And we can look for that answer. Oh, yes, Yisrael. For his people to prepare for battle. But we got a battle, Yisrael. And Yahweh knows just what to do to prepare his people. Oh, yes, he do, Yisrael. Oh, for he has commanded us when this time to be. Turn to Leviticus 23:23. Oh, keep on speaking, Moshe. Keep on talking to us, for we're here. It is open tonight. And Yahweh spoke to Moshe, saying, Leviticus 23:24 says, speak to the children of Israel, I will, Moshe, saying, in the seventh month, in the first day of the month, shall you have a Sabbath. Yes, we will. A memorial. Blowing of the shofar. Let me hear that shofar. Little one, little one. Yes, it said blast. For this is a cordial convocation unto Yah, YAHSHUA. Where you're at. Leviticus 23:25. It said, you will do no Sabbath work. That's what he said. This day is just unto Yahweh. Yes. Don't worry about doing no work. Yes. You just be still. Yes. And just celebrate today. Yes. Put Yah on your mind. Yes. Don't have no foolishness. Don't want to do no work around the house. Don't want to go places. Don't want to visit nobody. You just stay and fellowship with Yah. And he'll fellowship with you. Just give him his day. Yisrael, Yah. It ain't a day of where you be part of to Yah, a part to the world. No, it's his day, Yisrael, Yah. You give all yourself unto him, Yisrael. But you shall offer an offering made by fire to Yahweh. Yisrael, the offering of the praise. Not from just the speaking, but from the lips to let Yahweh know. Oh, that you're serious and you're for real about his feast day. Just that he invited you, Yisrael. Oh, you be for real to give him his praise and lift him up. Because he is worthy, Yisrael. He gave you a name and he chose his people to honor his day, Yisrael. Yes, I know they say, Yisrael, you don't need to honor his feast days. But Yisrael, don't you know that is a lie, Yisrael? For the world let us know that them are the days that he made for Yisrael. Not everybody, but those that he called Yisrael, they going to do as Yah commanded. They going to worship him on his feast days. They going to praise him, Yisrael. They going to rejoice, Yisrael. Not just one, not just two, but every feast day that Yah have commanded us. Oh, we're going to worship him, Yisrael. Don't worry about what they say, but worry about the one that we serve, the one that keeps us, Yisrael, the one that gives us strength, Yisrael, to endure, to go on through this valley, Yisrael. That's the one, oh, that we're going to trust in, Yisrael. That's the one we're going to listen to, Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, totally, to the great and mighty Israel. Oh, for the blowing of the shofar, Israel. As always, Israel. Oh, associated with the victory of YAHSHUA HaMashiach. Oh, that is why we blow it. Not just to be blown in Israel, for it give us victory, Israel. Oh, and let us know that you are right in the morning of the shofar. Yes, blow the shofar. Blow. Yes, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 YAHSHUA ben Nun. Joshua 6:2, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Yahweh said to YAHSHUA, see, I have given into your hand Jericho. Oh, they're reason, Yah. Tell us, YAHSHUA, let us know of the reason. And the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor. Oh, hallelujah. And he shall go around the city. Oh, how you men of war. And go around about the city once. Oh, Israel. Is there some more time? I did that once. Do it, Israel. This shall you do 6 days. YAHSHUA ben Nun, Joshua 6 and 4 says, and 7 Kohen, a completion, Israel, shall bear before the ark 7 shofar. Oh, blow the shofar. Oh, blow it. And then he goes on to say, the 7th day you shall compass the city. 7 times. And the Kohen shall blow with the shofar. Why, y'all? Why not 6? Why not 5? Oh, come on, YAHSHUA. YAHSHUA 6 and 5 say, and it shall come to pass. And when they make a long blast with the shofar, and when you hear the sound of the shofar, are you listening for that sound, Israel? All the people shout with a great shout. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. And what happened? YAHSHUA, what did they say should happen? When the sound of the 7th trumpet? Oh, Israel. And the wall of the city shall fall down flat, Israel. Oh, don't stop blowing the shofar. Oh, lift the shofar up, Israel. It says, and the city shall fall down flat, Israel. Oh, when the trumpet is blown, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't just think, Israel, that the blowing of the shofar don't mean nothing. Yes, it do, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And the people shall ascend up, every man straight before him, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. As YAHSHUA and Big Nun go on and tell us in Joshua 6 and 6, and YAHSHUA, the son of Nun, called the Kohen and said to them, take up the ark of the covenant of YAHWEH, hallelujah, in the completion of 7 Kohen, bear the 7 shofar before the ark of the covenant. Oh, hallelujah. And YAHSHUA ben Nun went on farther to tell his people, because he wanted his people to know what YAH had said. And he said to the people, pass on and compass the city. Let him that is armed pass on before the ark of the covenant of YAHWEH. Oh, why? Oh, YAHSHUA 6 and 8 said, and it came to pass when YAHSHUA had spoken by the voice of YAH to let YAH's people know that the 7 Kohen carrying 7 shofar pass on before YAHWEH, and they blew the shofar and the ark of the covenant of YAHWEH. It followed them. Oh, we're not through yet, Israel. YAHSHUA ben Nun, YAHSHUA 6 and 9 said, and the armed men went before the Kohen that blew the shofar, and the guard came after the ark, but the Kohen going on blowing with the shofar, blowing with the shofar, Israel, y'all. Blowing with the shofar, for they know that victory was there, Israel, y'all. Blow the shofar, for for victory and failures, Raah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, YAHSHUA. And what did they do, YAHSHUA? It's something that they did when they say, silent there, Israel, YAHSHUA. And YAHSHUA had commanded the people, saying, you shall not shout, nor make any noise with your voice. Why, YAHSHUA? We can't say nothing. Neither shall any word proceed out of your mouth. That is what the word say, Israel, y'all. Until what? Until the day I bid you to shout. And Israel, y'all going to give us that day. Then shall you shout, Israel, y'all. Oh, yes, Israel, y'all. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes. Your host will be none. Oh, you telling us some tough words, YAHSHUA. Oh, keep on talking to it. YAHSHUA 6 and 11. So the ark of YAHWEH compassed the city, going about it once. And they came into the camp and lodged in the camp. Oh, why YAHSHUA? YAHSHUA 6 and 12 said, and YAHSHUA rose up early in the morning. And Kohim took up the ark of YAHWEH. And YAHSHUA 6 and 13 said, and 7 Kohens, he still got the completion, burned 7 shofar of rams, ram horn, before the ark of YAHWEH went on continually and blew with the shofar. And the all men, when they went before them, but the guard came after the ark of YAHWEH. The Kohen kept on blowing with the shofar, for they know victory was in the blowing of that shofar. And YAHSHUA 6 to 14 say, and it's what day? And the second day, they compassed the city once and returned into the camp. So they did it a 6 day, Israel. Oh, YAHSHUA. There is a reason. Give us the reason. For we want to know. YAHSHUA. 6 and 15. And it came to pass on another day. But it's one more day than the 6 day this time, Israel. Oh, it said it came to pass on the 7th day. Oh, 7, Israel. Oh, completion, Israel. Oh, 7. Remember that 7. And then it goes on to say, 7 times, Israel. 7 times, Israel. Only on that day they compassed the city 7 times. YAHSHUA 6 and 16 said, and it came to pass at the 7th time when the Kohen blew with the shofar, YAHSHUA said to his people, shout, Israel! Oh, shout, Israel! Oh, yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, oh yes. For YAHWEH has given you the city because of the victory of the 7 times, Israel. YAHSHUA 6 and 17 says, and the city shall be accursed, even it, and all that are therein, Israel, to YAHWEH only. Oh, because Rahab the harlot. Oh, because she obeyed. She heard the sound. Oh, she heard the sound, Israel. Oh, it is to a lamb. And not only to a lamb, Israel. Oh, it is to that man, Israel. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hear, Israel. Oh, don't dismiss that sound. She and all that are with her in the house, because she hear the messengers, oh, that we sent Israel, Yah. Oh, YAHWEH will for Israel, Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Israel, Yah. Don't omit Israel, Yah, the shofar, when it's being sound, Israel, Yah. Let us hear. And let us give praise of our hallelujah unto YAHWEH Israel. Oh, for let's lift up that shofar. Let it hear the sound, Yisrael, of the shofar. Oh, for this is Yah's day. Oh, yes, little ones. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, I told her, Yah. Hallelujah. But YAHSHUA been none. Joshua 16 and 18 said, and you, and any wise, keep yourself from that accursed thing, Israel, Yah. Lest you make yourselves accursed, Israel, Yah, but not obeying of what Yah told us to do according to his Torah, Israel, Yah. When you take other accursed and make the camp of Israel, Yah, a curse or a trouble, Yah, Israel, Yah. And we don't want to bring the terrible wrath of Yah down upon us, Israel, Yah. YAHSHUA 6 and 19 tells us, but all the silver and all the gold and vessel of brass and iron are kodush unto YAHWEH. Yes, he made them. They should come in the treasure of YAHWEH. So don't worry. I don't look at these things that this world got. But look at the Almighty YAHWEH. He worth more than anything of this world, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah. YAHSHUA 6 and 19, 6 and 20. So the people shouted when the Kohen blew the shofar. That's right, little one, blow the shofar. Yes, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, that is a commandment from Yah. And it came to pass when the people heard the sound of the shofar. Are you hearing, Israel, Yah? That the people shouted with a great shout. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! And what you think happened, Israel, Yah? What you think became of the shout, Israel, Yah? Do you think it was just a shout, Israel, Yah? Do you think that YAHWEH wasn't hearing, Israel, Yah? Oh, Israel, Yah. Let me read on and tell you, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Of what that shout meant to Abba YAHWEH. That the wall fell down flat. So that the people went up into the city. And every man straight before him. They took the city, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Israel, Yah. And it said, Joshua 6 and 21. Oh, told you, I. And they utterly destroyed all that was in the city. Oh, just because of the sound of that shofar, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah. Both men and women, young. So don't tell me that Yah ain't gonna destroy the old, the young. Because it says right here, the young. And the old, and it goes on even the father to tell us, ox and sheep and ass with the edge of the sword. YAHWEH mean what he says, Israel, Yah. YAHWEH just not talking, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, totally, Yah. Ain't you glad you're on his side, Israel, Yah? But this is true, Israel, Yah. Oh, believe me, Israel, Yah. Oh, let's just wait, Israel, Yah. Let's just stand still, Israel, Yah. Don't worry about the battle, Israel, Yah. Yah already got it. In control, Israel, Yah. For the trumpet gonna sound, Israel, Yah. Yes, it is, Israel, Yah. Oh, Israel, Yah. Don't you know that is why we're here, Israel, Yah. On this great feast, for the gathering of Yahweh Israel. Yeah. Oh, hallelujah. Just to fellowship with Yahweh Israel. Yeah. To honor his day. For this is his day. For Israel, yeah. Our brother Shaul, he has something to tell us, Israel. Yeah. He want to speak to Israel, yeah, tonight. He want to let Israel, yeah, know. Oh, of the great promises of Yahweh. Let us know, Brother Shaul. By the Ruach, Brother Shaul, he said, turn to Thessalonians 4 and 13. That's all right. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But I would not have you to be ignorant. Toda Yah. Oh, for Yah tell his people and prepare his people, Israel. Ignorant brethren, concerning them who are asleep, let us awake, Israel. Let us hear of the words that be spoken tonight unto us, Israel. Or that we be prepared. Those that are dead in YAHSHUA, that you be sorry not, Israel, even as this world of the unbelievers have no emunah, no faith, Israel. But we have emunah, Israel, for we know the one of where our help coming from, Israel. We know the one that'll give us strength to endure. And it's not the thing that is life, Israel, y'all. For a man to have his hope in this life is more miserable, Israel, y'all. It's at Thessalonians 4 and 14. For if we believe that YAHSHUA rose again, Israel, y'all. Oh, Israel, y'all. Even so, them also which are asleep, Israel, yeah. Just like he got up that third day. Oh, it's going to be awakening for us, Israel, yeah. Oh, we're going to get up. The grave is not going to hold us down, Israel, yeah. When that trumpet sound, we're coming out, Israel, yeah. Oh, we're coming out. And it said, YAHSHUA HaMashiach with Yahweh will bring all side of that grave, Israel. Oh, Israel. I can't wait for that day to hear that trumpet sound. Oh, hallelujah. For Yahweh, oh, it's going to gather his people together. Oh, yes, Israel. Oh, what a day that will be, Israel. Oh, when all the people of Yah go to gathering home. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes. Thessalonians 4:15 said, for this we say to you, by the word of Yahweh, that we which are alive and remain to that coming of YAHSHUA HaMashiach shall not prevent them that which are asleep, Israel, yeah. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Yah's in control of everything, Israel, yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All we got to do is just wait. Thessalonians 4 and 16 say, oh, isn't Yah 12, Israel, yeah. For YAHSHUA HaMashiach, for himself, shall descend from the high Shemayim with a shout, Israel, yeah. Oh, all you got to do. Oh, don't just out there by yourself. Just wait. Just hold on. For that voice of that sound and trumpet, it's coming to you, Israel. It's coming to you, Israel, yeah. Yah ain't gonna leave you out, Israel, yeah. You're not alone that long. That one that's out there by yourself. Yah knows. Just don't be weary. Don't give up. Just hold on. Just hold on. Yahweh will keep you. Yahweh will stand by your side. Oh, I know that it's hard sometimes, but Yah's in control of everything. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, it goes on to say, with the voice of the chief, heavenly Malak, oh, we speak to you. Oh, with the shofar of Yahweh and the dead and HaMashiach, it says, shall rise first, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Yah. Oh, Abba rock you tonight, Abba Yahweh. What a great day, Abba Yahweh. Oh, for your feast, Abba Yahweh. Yes, Abba Yahweh. Oh, I told you. Oh, yes. That you didn't forget me, Yah. That you brought me right back to you, Yah. Hallelujah. Yes, I know I failed you, Yah. Oh, but by your tender mercy, you brought me into the place once again, Yah. It goes on to say, Thessalonians 4:17. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up where? Up together with him in the clouds, Israel, Yah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Yah. Oh, to meet YAHSHUA HaMashiach in the air. And so share. How long, Yah? Oh, a little while? A short time? A few minutes? We ever be with YAHSHUA HaMashiach? We ever be with YAHSHUA HaMashiach? Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, total Yah, total Yah. Hallelujah. Oh, and it works, Israel, Yah. Oh, waiting and listening to the sound of that shofar, Israel, Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Israel, Yah. So, Israel, Yah. Oh, Israel, Yah. So, we should comfort one another, Israel. We should strengthen one another, Israel. We should lift one another, Israel. We should encourage Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Israel. With the words, Israel, that Yahweh gave us, Israel. Oh, Israel. But we should stand, Israel, on Yah's Torah, Israel, of what he feed us with, Israel. Don't you know, Israel, told Yah that he prepared his people, Israel. He ain't going to let his people be in the valley, Israel, of knowing of where the strength come from to get the victory, Israel. Oh, Yah. I told him tonight, Israel. Israel. Oh, I told you for the feast. To let us know that the blowing of the trumpet ain't just a sound, but it's of Yahweh. And he's in that sound, Israel. All that his people can hear, to let him know. To come on with the hallelujahs unto me and to you of the moving of your feet and the opening of your mouth and the dancing unto him, Israel. For hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't let nobody tell you that his feast days don't mean anything, because they do, Israel. And if you the people of Israel, you will obey And I have any excuses, Israel, y'all. I know we say this and we say that, but to be a part of the feast of YAHSHUA, for after this feast, you have plenty of time to plan, and you should be in Yah's house to honor his feast, Israel, not having no excuses, Israel, for there is his day, and you proclaim you are Israel, so the next feast, be here, Israel. Be a part of Israel, people, Israel. Let us not have no excuses, Israel. Because when we stand before Yah, there will be no excuses. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes, I'll be right Yah for his feast tonight. Yes, I'm happy, Israel. I'm happy, Israel, to be here, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Zawkane, YarameYah, Israel. Oh, let us holler. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We barak Yahweh for that message from our Zawkane Benjamin, Israel. So beautiful, full of energy, of zeal, zest, refreshment. I barak Yah for that. Hallelujah. But we don't sit in here in vain, shouting and blowing the shofar and beating the timbrels. But it's all that remains, Zawkane, remember even the very voice of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. What a beautiful message, Zawkane. Hallelujah. I told the Yahweh for that. You don't get this just anywhere, Yisrael. Hallelujah. A message like that. We told the Yahweh for that. Hallelujah. So we told the Yahweh for that, for this feast. This in gathering of the trumpets, the shofar. At this time, we want to ask that Ach Shimri, if you will, my Ach, you will come forth with the word of Yah has placed in your left tonight. Hallelujah. This is one of our Ach that has known even me from
my teenage years.
Hallelujah. And I brought Yahweh for him. Great example unto us, young. Hallelujah.
Yes. Well, I'm excited tonight. Conditions of Yah. Hallelujah. For Yah is truly in the place tonight. Hallelujah. Yes. For my love is being barat. Hallelujah. And I told Yah for another Feast of Trumpets tonight. Hallelujah. And he is truly in the place. If we can't feel that, if we can't see it, then something is wrong. Something is truly wrong. For he is here tonight. Just a few of us. But he is in the midst. So that's all that's important. That Yah is here tonight. And I'm a soldier. Hallelujah. And I'm a soldier in this army of Yahweh. I'm a soldier in this army. If I die, then let me die in this army of Yahweh. If I die, let me die in this army. I'm a soldier in this army of Yahweh. I'm a soldier in this army. I'm a soldier in this army of Yahweh. I'm a soldier in this army. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. Yes. But truly, this is a feast, conditions of Yah. Hallelujah. This is a feast. I'm feasting tonight. Hallelujah. I'm full already. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's very important, conditions of Yah. It says the feast of the trumpet, of the blowing of the shofar. It says that it is a permanent sign for the preparation of Yah. But the most important thing, it says Yah's true nation. Hallelujah. For Yah's true nation. Yah calls his peoples from far and near, Hallelujah. He calls them unto a feast day. Yes, hallelujah. And you think Yah doesn't know what he's doing? Yes, he knows what he's doing. Yes, he calls his people. Yes, the true ones. Yes, not just any people. Right. His people. Yes, and you think that when he calls his people together, on, as I said, he doesn't know what he's doing? Yes, he because when he calls his people together from far and near, yes, it brings about a strength to see people of like faith. Hallelujah. People of the same emunah, striving to walk before the Abba in purity. Hallelujah. In sincerity. Hallelujah. As brothers, as ox and a colt. Hallelujah. Yah knows what he's doing when he calls his feast days. He didn't put them in this book for no reason. There's a purpose. Hallelujah. He put them there for a purpose, that we may be strengthened by one the other. Hallelujah. That's what it's for. Yah knows what he's doing. And it brings about the strength. Those of you that are a little older, you've attended family reunions and things of that sort, things of that nature, gatherings around your natural kinsmen. And it done a little something for you to see them, to visit them. Hallelujah. So Yah knows exactly what he's doing. Where do you think they got it from? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yah knows what he's doing. So it's very important to keep Yah's feast days. The world can say what they want. It's in the book. And if we are of the emunah of Yah, then we should abide by the book and do what he says. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says it's a time to gather. And what are we gathering for? To hear the will, to hear the purpose of our Abba, so we may become more like him. That we may walk, hallelujah, walk with strength. That we may be, as Zawkane Benjamin always say, we'll be a city, a light, that sit upon that hill. Hallelujah. That people may inquire, what is it about those people? Hallelujah. Total Yah. Hallelujah. I'm going to start off here, Kedushas of Yah, and in Judges, Shoftim 6 and 33. It says, then all the Midianites and the Amalekites and the children of the east were gathered together and went over and pitched in the valley of Jezreel. 6 and 34. It said, but the Ruah of Yah. That's all right. The Ruah of Yah came upon Gideon. Oh, beautiful. And he blew the shofar. Oh, hallelujah. Right. Yes. He blew the shofar. He sounded the warning. Hallelujah. He blew the shofar. Hallelujah. And Beezer was gathered after him. 6 and 35, it said, and Gideon, he sent messengers throughout all Manasseh, who also was gathered after him. So they had to have heard that shofar. Hallelujah. Do we hear the shofar tonight, Kedushas of Yah? Hallelujah. Do we hear the importance of this shofar? Do we not just hear Zawkane Benjamin? Do we not just not hear that shofar? Huh? Do we not hear that ruah? Hallelujah. And they heard the shofar. They had to have heard it. And it says, and he sent messages to Asher and to Zebulun and to Naphtali. And they came up to meet them. Hallelujah. Judges 6 and 36. And it says, and Gideon said to Yah, if you will deliver Israel by my hand, as you have said. It says, behold, I will put a fleece of wool in the floor. And if the dew be on the fleece only, and it be dry upon all the earth beside, then shall I know that you will deliver Israel by my hand, as you have said. And we know the continuance of this story. He delivered Israel. Huh? Because they heard the sound of the shofar. Hallelujah. They came from far and near. Hallelujah. They was attentive to their Abba. Hallelujah. They gathered in one accord, of one mind, of the same like emunah, the same faith, to strengthen, to be a strength one unto the other, a family. Hallelujah. That's what they did. They gathered. Hallelujah. And we as a people of Yah, we must. There are plenty sounds out here today. Plenty sounds. Sounds of things of the flesh, Y'all don't hear me. Sounds of things of wickedness and sin, nothing pertaining to the things of Yah. But we as the people of Yah, we must be sure of the sound of this shofar that we're hearing. Hallelujah. We must be sure of this sound. We're taken by all other kind of sounds. Our families. Hallelujah. Our wives. Hallelujah. Our children. The book tells us to save ourselves. Hear the sound of this shofar. We must save ourselves. We can't save anyone but our own self. He's given us a chance tonight. Hallelujah. He's given it to us. Hallelujah. We must hear the sound of the shofar. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 14 and 8. It says, for if the shofar give an uncertain sound. Are y'all with me? He said, if it give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself to the battle? So every instrument has a different sound, does it not? A flute has the sound of a flute. A guitar has the sound of a guitar. And a trumpet has the sound of a trumpet. We got to know as the people of Yah which sound. We got to be sure of that sound that we're listening for. And we're listening for the sound of the voice of Yah, his word, his Torah. That's the sound we're listening for. That we may be strengthened as a people. That we may walk with strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the sound that we should be assured. We should know that sound. If we have his emunah, we should know his sound. We should hear the sound of that shofar. Hallelujah. That's what we should be attentive to. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says here, it says, when the kingdom of Yah, HaMashiach, it says, this prophecy is about the coming of YAHSHUA, the power of his kingdom. Yes, come on. There must be a sure sounding. Sure it must be. And I have some examples here in Zechariah. Zechariah 9 and 9, it says, rejoice greatly, yes. O daughter of Zion. Yes. Hallelujah. It says, shout. Hallelujah. Shout. Blow the shofar. Hallelujah. We must be sure. Hallelujah. Shadow daughter of Jerusalem. Behold. Hallelujah. It says, behold, your king comes. He's coming, conditions. It says, behold, your king's come. Your king comes to you. He said, he is just. And having deliverance. Lowly. And riding upon an ass. And upon a coat. The fall. The fall of an ass. Hallelujah. And that's just fulfilling Torah. That's fulfilling Torah. It says in Matthew 21 and 5, fulfilling Torah, it says, tell you, the daughter of Zion, behold, your king comes to you, meek, and sitting upon an ass, and a coat, and the fall of an ass. Hallelujah. Does that not back up the first one I just read? That's the Torah of Yah. See, we got to hear this shofar, conditions of Yah. We must hear it. We must not hear the things of this world. We must not listen to what this world is putting out here today. It's taking the people to hell in a handbasket. You can't meet anyone out here that has any sense. Hallelujah. And they may start off, yeah, this and that, and for you know, where are they? Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? It's some crazy people out here today. I drive and I meet them all the time. Women and men. It's crazy out here today. We must hear the sound of the shofar. We're not here by chance. We're not here by chance. We that are sitting here tonight, it is the mercies of Yah. We may take it for granted, but it's the mercies of Yah. It's the mercies of Yah. It's his kasid. Hallelujah. It's what he is doing. Hallelujah. So we must hear the sound of this shofar. It says here in Zechariah 9 and 10, it says, and I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall speak shalom to the heathen, and his dominion shall be from sea even to sea, and from the river even to the ends of the Olam. 9:11, it says, and as for you also, by the blood of your covenant, hallelujah, I have sent forth your prisoners out of the pit wherein is no water. Hallelujah. It says, turn you, 9 and 12, it says, turn you to be strong. Hold, to be stronghold. You, prisoners of Tikvah, our hope. Are we not prisoners? I want to be a prisoner of Yah. Hallelujah. I'd rather be a prisoner of Yah and hear this shofar tonight than be a prisoner of this world, I hear. Because what does HaSatan have to offer his people? You tell me. What does he have to offer them? But misery, pain, turmoil. They look bad. They feel bad. And there is no escaping. I'd rather be a prisoner of Yah. Suffer these small things. He said, for my yoke is easy. Why is it easy? Because we put it all in his hands. Hallelujah. We put it all in his hands. He said, for my yoke is easy. I'd rather be a prisoner of Almighty Yah and suffer with the people of Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, a tikvah of hope. Even today do I declare that I will render double to you. Hallelujah. To be a prisoner of Yah, he's going to render double unto us. Double. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says in Zechariah 9:13, it says, when I have bent Yahuda for me, fill the bowl with Ephraim and raise up your sons, O Zion, against your sons, O Greece, and made you as a sword of mighty men. And Yahweh, Zechariah 9:14, he says, and Yahweh shall be seen over them, and his arrow shall go forth. His arrow shall go forth as lightning. As lightning. And who is that lightning? YAHSHUA is that light. Hallelujah. YAHSHUA is that light. It says, and the sovereign Yah shall blow the shofar. Hallelujah. And shall go with whirlwinds of the south. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, 9:15, it says, Yahweh of hosts shall defend them. Hallelujah. Yah shall defend them. Hallelujah. If we adhere to the sound of the shofar, we obey his commandments, we walk within his word. Hallelujah. We stick together as a family. Hallelujah. The people of Yah. We suffer one another. Hallelujah. We stand in coherence one with the other. Hallelujah. He says that Yah shall defend him. Who is them? Israel. Hallelujah. And they shall devour and subdue with sling stones. And they shall drink and make noise as through wine. And they shall be filled like bowls and as corners, as the corners of the altar. Hallelujah. You see the promises of Yah? Hallelujah. You see the promises of Yah, what he's going to do for his people? We hear the sound of this shofar. Hallelujah. That's why it's so important that we keep the feast days. Hallelujah. That's why it's so important, condition of Yah. It says double, double. And it says now in Zechariah 9:16, it says, Yahweh, their Abba, shall deliver them in that day as the flock of his people. For they shall be stones. I want to be that stone. Hallelujah. I want to be that stone. It says, for they shall be as stones of a crown. Lift it up. Hallelujah. It says, lift it up as a signal upon his head. Conditions of Yah. Hallelujah. It says, we shall be stones. Hallelujah, in the crown. Hallelujah. Todaya. Hallelujah. It says here in Matthew 24:29, this prophecy of Zechariah in his truth, it says, immediately after tribulation of those days, shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from the Shemayams, and the powers of the Shemayam shall be shaken. Hallelujah. And it says, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in the Shemayam. It says, and then shall all the tribes of the Olam mourn. Hallelujah. It says, then shall all the tribes mourn. It says, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds. Hallelujah. Of the Shemayans with power and great splendor. It says they shall see. Hallelujah. Say, we shall see. It says 24 and 31, Matthew says, and YAHWEH shall send his melekim with a great sound. Hallelujah. With a great sound. Hallelujah. With a great sound of the shofar. Hallelujah. With a great sound. Hallelujah. With a great sound. Hallelujah. And it says, and they shall gather. They shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of the Shemayim to the other. Hallelujah. From one end unto the other. Are we not gathered here today from one end of the Olam to the other? Hallelujah. Are we not gathered? Todaya. Hallelujah. And as I look out here tonight, we're gathered from all the different places. South Africa, Detroit, Marshfield, Charlotte, different places. All different places where I gather here today. And can we not see the Ruach HaKodesh of y'all here tonight? As YarameYah said, you don't get this. You don't get this type of truth. This type of sincerity. This type of family organized. You don't get this. There's so much going on out there. People are selfish. They're not true. But when people can come together and live this way, to hear this shofar, there's sincerity there. Hallelujah. There has to be. Because you're not going to get it, those people out there to live this way. Hallelujah. That's the only way you can hear the sound of his shofar. He said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. Hallelujah. Live collectively. Hallelujah. Todayah. Hallelujah. It says here, the tabernacle is filled with honor of Yah. And this is what we are looking for here tonight. We're looking for that tonight. I'm going to 2 Chronicles, Deuteronomy. I have just a few more scriptures here. It says, and it came to pass when the Kohen will come out of the Kodesh place. For all the Kohen that were present were Kodesh and did yet serve by their assigned divisions. 5 and 12, it says, also the Levites, which were the singers. Do we have singers here tonight? Yes. Hallelujah. Do we have singers here tonight? It said the singers and all of them of Abs and Heman and Udathon with their sons and their brethren being arrayed in white linen, having cymbals. Do we have cymbals here tonight? Hallelujah. Psalteries, harps, stood at the east. Hallelujah. Stood at the east end of the altar. And with them, 120 Kohen, sounding with the shofars. Hallelujah. Sounding with the shofars. And it said, it came even to pass, as the shofar and the singers were as one, to make one sound, to be heard in the praising and the thanking Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. It says, and when they lifted up, y'all don't hear me. It says, when they lifted up their voice, hallelujah, with the shofars, hallelujah, with the cymbals, hallelujah, with the instruments, hallelujah, of music and praise unto Yah, saying, for he is tough, hallelujah, for his kindness endures forever. That being in the bed was filled with a cloud. Do we not see that cloud in here tonight? Hallelujah. Even in the bed of Yah. Hallelujah. It says, so that the Kohen could not stand to minister, but reason of the cloud. Hallelujah. And Yah had filled the bed of Yah. Hallelujah. He has filled his bed tonight, goodness of Yah. Hallelujah. He has filled it with praise. Hallelujah. He has filled it with his Ruah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yah is here tonight, goodness of Yah. Hallelujah. For he is here. So let us praise him and thank him. Give Todah unto Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. For he's given us another chance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. He's given us another chance. His conceits endure forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let us be encouraged, conditions of Yah. Hallelujah. Let us eat upon these fruit. Hallelujah. This word of Yah. For he has given it unto us for that purpose, that we may make it into his, that we may dwell with him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For we are chosen people. We are set aside people. We are those stones, those jewels that's going to be in his crown. So let us stand. Let us endure. Hallelujah. Let us hear the shofar. Hallelujah. YarameYah. Hallelujah. Todah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What a beautiful message from our ox Shimri. Zawkane Benjamin Yisrael. I tell you what, my lab is filled tonight from the beauty and the simplicity, and it's just more than words can say, Yisrael. But y'all brought Yahweh for our ox and our Zawkane to take the time to study and to find the nuances of Torah truth that we may understand what Yahweh is saying is our. It's not complicated what Yahweh commands us to do, Yisrael. That even the babe could understand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a beautiful evening Yahweh has given us. Of truth, encouragement, prophecy. We've got it. We have received it all tonight, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just a few words, Yisrael. I'm not going to be long tonight. Such a beautiful time. So many wonderful things have been heard tonight, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Let me just begin here, the reading in Numbers, Bemidbar, chapter 1, chapter 10, verse 1. And the expression of this, Yisrael, is just understanding that we know that Yahweh, he's the beginning and he's the end. He's the creator of all things. The season has been started by the sounding of the shofar. And when everything is said, when everything is done, when it comes to completion, it's going to be that same sound of the shofar, that for sure sound, that when we hear it, we will know that the end of all things have come to, in this life, at this time, to fruition. But yet, it's still not the end, because we're in him. We're in Almighty Yah. We're in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. So there's never an end, Yisrael, for the chosen, for the house, for the elect of Almighty Yah. So let me begin here. It says, and Yahweh, he spake unto Moshe, saying, make you two trumpets, two shofars of silver. Very important. There's so many details in this, Yisrael. I'm not going to get into that tonight, because it's just so much in this, as Raah that we have spoken concerning the trumpet and its meaning, what it entails, what it says unto us, Yisrael. But here he says, to make of you two silver trumpets. What are the purpose of these trumpets that Yahweh had commanded Moshe to make from this silver? It says that the whole piece shall you make them. No separate parts. I want it to be complete. I want it to be whole. Just as Yahweh's Torah. It is strong. It is loud. It is powerful. It is whole. It's not to be divided. He said, I want these instruments of silver, and I want them to be made whole. We see the many instruments of today, somewhat they have lost their simplicity and their beauty. Why? Because they have so many moving parts today, so many fancy things you can do with them. But yet Yahweh said that my word is not to be tampered with. My ish is not to be tampered with. I want it solid. I want it complete. I want it whole. So he says, for the shofar, it says, it shall be sound. not broken up. It should be sure. And the dead, it says, shall be rise. I'm sorry. It says, make you two trumpets of silver. Got ahead of myself there. And a whole piece of it you shall make them. That you may use them, it says, for the calling.
That's all right, my friend.
The calling.
That's beautiful.
That's the mikra.
Yeah.
Isn't that why we hear? Have we not been called Yisrael? Yeah. It is by the sure sound of the mikra, of the shofar, of the gathering, the completeness, the whole, the sum of Yisrael.
Yeah.
That is what the purpose of these two shofars are for. Yeah. For the calling, or for the mikra, the gathering, the convocation, the reading, the calling together.
Yeah.
That's what the purpose of it is, YAHWEH. Have not YAH gathered us?
Yeah.
Has He not gathered Yisrael?
Yeah.
Don't think we're not gathered. Even though we are somewhat in different places, YAH has gathered Yisrael.
Yeah.
We may be separated physically, but not in the Ruach, Yisrael.
Yeah.
YAH has gathered us. He has not lost touch with His people, with His elect. He has not left us, Yisrael. He says here that for the calling, for the mikra, the convocation, the reading, the calling together, or the Kodesh assembly. Continuing in verse 2, of the assembly, and for also the journey. Are we not in a journey? Yisrael. This world is not a home. We're looking for a kingdom, an establishment that has not been made by man's hands, but it has been made by the hands of Almighty YAHWEH. It says also for the pulling up of the stakes. We know that for different types of of buildings and tents, they're held down by stakes. They're secured, are they not? We are secure in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. Yet we are in the world, but we're not of the world. So YAHWEH is saying by the blowing of the shofar to pull up the stakes. We're going to move on in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. We're not going to be held down by the things of this life, by the things of the world. We're not going to allow those things to hold us down. So he said, by the sound of the shofar, it is for the calling, it's for the gathering, it's for us to pull up, to let go of these weights and these sins that so easily beset us, and to move on. What are we waiting for, Yisrael? Are we not waiting for the coming of YAHSHUA HaMashiach? Let me read on. The pulling up of the stakes, it also means the breaking of the camp. A tent, you break it down, you prepare it. Are we not heading for the season of the tents?
Yes.
Yisrael. Sukkot.
Yes.
That we are dwelling in earthly tabernacles.
Cool.
That are just for a moment, Yisrael. We're going to move on from this fleshly stuff.
Yeah.
We're going to pull up these tanks in this land.
Yeah.
And we're going to move on into the land that YAHWEH has elected for Yisrael.
Yeah.
New Jerusalem. Hallelujah. I have not ground my stakes in this life. I have not made this world my home. This is not my dwelling place, only but for a time. So I'm going to pull up my stakes at the hearing of the shofar. I want to be ready to move. Break down my tents. It says settling out or getting prepared also for the journey or for the sojourn, Yisrael. Out of this camp, out of this place, out of this life. We shall all be changed in a moment, Yisrael, in the twinkling of an eye. So quickly. YAH is not going to prolong the change, Yisrael. Let us move on. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51. There's a few examples here. Corinthians and Thessalonians, I do want to read concerning this shofar. The last shofar. The shofar of this in gathering, these two silver shofars that YAH even shabbat, even at the last times, Yisrael. It says here in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed.
Yes.
In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last shofar.
Yes.
at this last ingathering. We're going to all gather together for this final finale, if I may use that term, Yisrael. And for the shofar, it shall sound. The dead and YAHSHUA Messiah, they shall be rise up and corrupted. This shofar of assurance of the Torah of Almighty YAHWEH, it raises us up from the dead, Yisrael. We're not going to be held down for the things of this life. We're not going to allow sin to hold us down, Yisrael. But we're going to rise up, incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this incorruptible, or this corruptible, must put on incorruption. It must put on incorruption, Yisrael. It's only going to be at the sounding of the shofar, the sounding of the word, the sure word of Almighty YAHWEH. This one piece of this shofar, this trumpet, that shall sound assured and shall sound aloud. As our Akshemi said, we must be prepared and know and be ready for the sound of the shofar of Almighty YAHWEH. It said this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruption shall put on incorruption and this mortal shall put on immortality, then we shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, that death is swallowed up in Teshua. Yeah. Hallelujah. We have Teshua tonight. We have victory in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. The shofar has sounded, Yisrael. All we have to do is just shout for Teshua, for victory. Hallelujah. And everything that is high, that has lifted up the walls, that has kept us out of the promises and out of the will of Almighty YAH shall come down. It shall be brought down as our Zawkane Ben Ami Abash expressed unto us. It shall all fall down, Yisrael. We must follow the Torah of Almighty YAHWEH in every step, in every way. As it says also here in 1 Thessalonians, another example, Yisrael, of the shofar, the trumpets. Remember, there's two trumpets, Yisrael, that we should have in our left, that we should blow daily. You know, there's an old saying that says that one going around tooting their horn, or they're boasting of themselves. Well, we boast in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. So we're going to blow the shofar. We're going to blow the horn for him, Yisrael. Hallelujah. It says in 1 Thessalonians 4 and 13 that, but I will not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning them that are asleep, that you sorrow not. We should not sorrow, be sorrowful for those that have gone on before us, Yisrael. Even as others which have no hope. We have hope in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. Have not the trumpet sounded tonight? With victory, with assurance, Yisrael. So we should not be sorrowful. Verse 14. For if we believe that YAHSHUA HaMashiach died and rose again, even so them also which are asleep in YAHSHUA Messiah will also be raised in him. And will bring... Oh, and he will bring them with him. Verse 15. For this we say to you by the word, the Torah of YAHWEH, that we which are alive and remain to the coming of YAHSHUA HaMashiach, again, the sound of the shofar, for he shall come with the sound of the art malak, Yisrael, which are alive and remain until the coming of YAHSHUA HaMashiach, shall not prevent them which are asleep. For YAHSHUA HaMashiach himself shall descend from the Shemayims with a shout, with the voice of the chief Malak, and with the shofar of Almighty YAH. He is the shofar of Almighty YAHWEH. He shall sound loud and assure Yisrael. And we which are alive and remain, we shall hear. And not only those, but those that have gone on from this life, they shall also hear. The dead shall arise, Yisrael, at the sounding of the shofar. The dead in YAHSHUA HaMashiach, it says here in verse 16, shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be called up together with them in the Shemayim, in the clouds, to meet YAHSHUA HaMashiach in the air. And so shall we ever be with our master, YAHSHUA HaMashiach. After the sounding of that shofar, Yisrael, after that great sound when he cracks the sky. Therefore, comfort one another with these words, as we heard Zawkane Ben Ami Abash. My last verses here, as we bring this beautiful occasion to a close, in B'minbar Numbers chapter 10, verse 3. Hallelujah. And when they shall blow with them, it's talking about the shofar, all the assembly shall assemble themselves together. Remember, we're talking about those shofars, the gather, the calling out of these two silver shofars that Yahweh commanded to be made for the calling of the convocation, the Kodesh convocation, and also the ingathering of Yisra'iyah. And when they shall blow with them, all the assembly shall assemble themselves to you at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. And if they blow but with one trumpet, it says, when the princes, which are the heads of thousands of Yisra'iyah, shall gather themselves together also to you. Verse 5. And when you blow an alarm, then the camps, the ingathering, the camps that lie on the east parts, they shall go forward. They are prepared. They know that this is only a home or a place to gather for a moment. But at the sound of this shofar, it is time to move on. It is time to press on. It is time for us to move on, Yisra'iyah. It's time for us, as my Avot used to say, marking time, being in just one place. It's time for us to move on forward in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. It says, when you blow an alarm, the camps that lie on the eastward parts, they shall go forward. And when you blow an alarm on the second time, the camps that lie on the south side, they shall go their journey. They shall blow an alarm for their journeys. But when the congregation is to be gathered together, this is concerning the blowing and the types of blowing, and how many times the shofar shall be blown, Yisra'iyah. But when the congregation shall be gathered together, you shall blow, but you shall not sound the alarm. And the sons of Aharon, the Kohen, shall blow with the trumpets, and they shall be to you for an ordinance forever throughout your generations. We should blow these shofars, Yisra'iyah. Sound the alarm when it is necessary to. We should sound the alarm. Why? Because as we heard our ox tonight, the battle is just near at hand, Yisra'iyah. But also there's a blowing of the shofar when it's time for us to ingather. And there's a blowing of the shofar when it's time for us to depart, Yisra'iyah. Just a few more scriptures here. Two more scriptures. And if you go to war in your land against the enemy that pursues you, are we not pursued by the enemy? Are we not pursued by our thoughts and our emotions, Yisra'iyah? If we don't keep those things in check, if we don't keep the flesh impaled, Yisra'iyah. He said, if you go to war in your land against the enemy that oppresses you, then shall you blow the alarm with the trumpets. And you shall remember before Yahweh your Almighty, and you shall be delivered from your enemies. So let us remember at the blowing of the shofar, whatever shofar it may be, that we, above all things, remember Almighty Yahweh. For he is our deliverance, Yisra'iyah. He is our help in the time of need. And my last verse tonight. Also in the day of your gladness. Are we not glad, Yisra'iyah? There also shall be an important time where there shall be no more crying, no more sickness, no more pain. The things that we experience in life, Yisra'iyah, that are unfair and so brutal at times. It says here that also in the day of your gladness and in your shalom days, your solemn days, and in the beginning of your months, you shall blow with the trumpet over your burnt offerings. Have we brought a burnt offering before Almighty Yah? The praises, extolling his name. We have offered it unto Almighty Yahweh from YAHSHUA HaMashiach, which is our altar, unto Almighty Yahweh with fire tonight. And it's a sweet smelling savor unto his nostrils, Yisra'iyah. And over, that's about the sacrifices of your shalom offerings. Do we have our shalom offerings with us tonight, Yisra'iyah? Let us offer the offering of shalom unto Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. And your shalom offerings, why? That they may be to you for a memorial before Yahweh, your Almighty. And he says this, I am Yahweh, your Almighty. Hallelujah. Yahweh is our great one. He is our Almighty. He is our Abba. So let our ears and our hearts be open to the sounding of the shofar. Hallelujah. Yahweh Barak, you conditions of Yah. Those that are listening by via live stream, I have a few announcements to make before we turn this beautiful time, this beautification, just for a close for now. Hallelujah. Day of Atonement, YAHSHUA is coming up soon. It will be here before we know it in about a week, a few days. Day of Atonement, October the 16th. Service will begin on Tuesday evening at 7 o'clock p.m. October the 15th, evening service will start. Tabernacle will also start in October the 21st. Service is also at 7 o'clock p.m. sundown to that eve of the 20th, which is the last great day. We shall also have a service then, Yisrael, at 7 o'clock p.m., which will be the 27th. Now, if I'm not mistaken, also this information is on YahwehSword.org concerning the times and the dates, Yisrael. So let us be attentive. Let us listen. Let us participate. Wherever you are, wherever you listen, Yisrael, to these feast days, these Kodesh days, and let us gather in YAHSHUA's mighty name. Hallelujah. Let's stand to our feet tonight, Yisrael. Been a beautiful time, a beautiful occasion. I have learned and garnered so much tonight, Yisrael. I brought Yahweh for all things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us stand, let us shub. Almighty Yahweh, we barak you for this special time. This day of the shofar, the blowing of the shofar, and we have heard your word as it was blown out unto us, Almighty Yahweh. Both the dead and alive, Almighty Yahweh, has been risen on this day as we adhere unto your words, Abba Yahweh, of life and of light, Almighty Yahweh. We do ask that those that are listening by Viv Live Stream, Abba Yahweh, those that have come from near and afar, as I said often, that you would take them home, Abba Yahweh, safely, that your malak would be encamped around, call all Yisrael tonight, and that you would give your beloved people, your chosen people, sweet rest tonight on this Shabbaton, as we rest in your Torah and in YAHSHUA HaMashiach. And all things we give you, Todah. And we barak you, Abba Yahweh, and we sound the shofar in YAHSHUA's name. We cry out, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Yah Barak Kol Yisrael, hallelujah, Shabbat Shalom, hallelujah.